On our special segment Newsline telecast on Primetime News last night, former Sri Lankan permanent representative to the UN in Geneva, Tamara Kunanayakam, revealed that the report of the audit conducted into the renovation of the permanent representative's residence in Geneva was submitted to MP Sajin Devas Gunawardena. We made direct inquiries from the monitoring MP of the Ministry of External Affairs to ascertain the truth of the matter.
Tamara Kurunayakam alleges that the renovation of the permanent representative's residence was entrusted to a company owned by the LTTE. She also alleges that the owners of this company have been previously imprisoned. She also revealed that this was not a construction company but a finance company. What is the truth of the matter?
Are you saying that when Tamara Kurunayakam was the ambassador, the contract to renovate the official residence was given by Shenuka Siniratna's husband? That cannot be done. Usually, when you are the ambassador, you decide who to give it to, in keeping with government procedures. Will we, who went to war with the LTTE, give contracts to the LTTE? That is all I have to say.
Tamara Kurunayakam says that there were many financial irregularities. She added that she had requested the president to order an audit and that the audit report was later submitted to you.
I reject that. I have received nothing. I do not know anything about this. I do not look into any of these things either. Those are what you call establishment matter. I do not carry much weight in establishment matters. There are separate OABs for this. They are responsible for that. I have not received such a thing. I can say that clearly, I have not received anything and I do not know about it either.
Although the monitoring MP of the Ministry of External Affairs, Sajin Devas Gunawardena, claims he never received such a report, Tamara Kurunayakam stated with responsibility yesterday in three languages on our segment Newsline that this audit report was compiled and that it was now in the hands of the monitoring MP.
Soon after you took up your appointment in Geneva, you ordered an audit into the renovation of the High Commission premises. What was the purpose of this audit?
When you take over a job, you have to see that the table is clear. The residence where I was living, the official residence, was actually had before I arrived by a company whose the heads of the company had been arrested by the Swiss for LTT activities. They'd been in prison. And I found that the estimates, that the contract was given on the basis of estimates that were totally wrong. I had discovered that the house, the residence was being watched. And that's also the reason I informed the police and I asked them if they could check if there was anything, any electronic material that had been installed in the house. And they said, well, of course we can't do it because this is extraterritorial. You have to ask your government to do it. Which is why then I asked the government to do, one is the financial audit and the second is to look into the security matters. Because not only because of my own security, but this is the official residence. This is the Sri Lankan state. So if there were microphones in there and we were being watched and they heard everything, the enemy knows exactly what you're going to do.
A former MP, Vasantha Samarasinghe, who's in the JVP, he says that this audit was carried out and that the report was compiled and then submitted to higher authorities here in Colombo. And he says that no action was taken subsequent to that. Why? Because as you point out, it's a serious issue, both financially and security-wise. Why was no action taken at all?
I think that's the question you should be asking from those who have the report. To my understanding, that the report was handed over to Sajin Bas to act upon. And I think you should ask Sajin Bas that question and now the present secretary, Shenuka Siniratna.